My name is Dracula. I bid you welcome. Welcome to my house. This is the Constellation Masquerade. We have a few rules for the audience. One of them is no flash pictures on the contestant. Anyone taking a flash picture will be taken out, killed, and eaten. You see, you're no longer the top of the food chain. I am. Now, we will be running the masquerade, first the young fans, and then the general contestants. But unfortunately, they won't let me MC this masquerade. They're afraid I'll scare the children. And there's some of them I wouldn't mind. So they insisted that I get someone else to do my job. Ladies and gentlemen, the MC of the Constellation Masquerade, Patrick Kennedy.
Good evening, and thank you, Count, for that lovely introduction. I fear, however, the Count's introduction is just a little incomplete. He is not aware of my status in the Congregation of Our Lady of Perpetual Light, and my rank therein. Which is Monsignor, and of my mission to the Curia of Our Lady, which is that exorcist no flame rule, you know. My dear Count, I have a steak for you in here. Peggy, not that. Oh, something holy? Yeah, just holy mackerel. I've got it.
Booby, have you got the wrong vampire?
The seminary of the Curia of Our Lady, our motto is Semper Paratus. And tonight's first young fan contestant, from DC Comics, The Green Arrow. The costume is presented by Jeremy Bob, designed and made by Joan Bob. Our next young fan contestant is a Pegasus. Costume is presented by Rachel Bob, designed and made by the contestant. Little Fuzzy. Her Pappy Jack is a prop. costumers presented by Amber Dion. Costume design and construction by Joanna Dion. The three Thumbelinas, Crystal, Diamond, and Sparkle. Costume presented by Genevieve Harrigan, Melissa Pierce, and Judy Pierce. Costumes designed and made by the wearers. Puissant Majesty, Mav, Queen of the Fairies of England, Ireland, Scotland, and Wales, and the Isle of Man. The costume is designed and worn by Alice Lewis. Construction by Suford Lewis. Luke Skywalker and Jedi Mother. It is a dark time for the Old Republic. Fleeing from the evil clutches of the sinister Emperor, and Anakin Skywalker, Rhea Skywalker, also a Jedi Knight, separates her twin children, leaving her daughter Leia in the protective care of good friends on Alderaan. She is now en route to Tatooine to leave her son with relatives, knowing as she does that she will never see him again. It is the beginning of the end of the era for the Jedi. Anakin, Rhea's husband, has joined forces with the evil Emperor. Luke and Leia's lives are in jeopardy if they are to remain with their mother. Rhea and Luke Skywalker are Shirley and Mark Weaver. Costume designed by Shirley Weaver. Obi-Wan Jr. Richard Sheminsky, ladies and gentlemen, as Obi-Wan Jr. The Force is with that kid. Now, there are people who are in the aisles. We ask that you clear those aisles. There is a great deal of seating in the back, and the machine here... Did you hear that? What? Oh.
Children of the night, shut up! Shouldn't we tell the audience, first of all, shouldn't we introduce the children's judges who just went off?
The children's judges were B. Joe Trimble and Barbie Johnson.
Right.
Just the two.
Right? Just two.
Okay.
The judges who are being seated now at the table facing the runway. My chief judge for the general costuming, Sally Fink. Sally is herself a master costumer in Worldcons, several time Worldcon winner. Next to Sally, Sandra Mizell. Also a master costumer, as well as a very, very fine author. represents the East. Sandra represents the Midwest, representing the West. Adrian Martine Barnes. Again, Adrian is a world-class master costumer and an author. Her most recent science fiction book is The Dragon Rises. A couple of up-and-coming artists that watch for them, they're going to do big things. Kelly Fries and Michael Whalen. Sitting at the far end of the table, the beautiful Mr. William Rotzler. Author of Rotzler's Rules, among other things. Next to Bill is Maureen Garrett, representing Star Wars and Lucasfilms. And I'm not sure, am I correct, the gentleman next to Maureen is Sid Gannis, also representing Lucasfilms. Next to Sid is Marv Wolfman of DC Comics. And next to Marv is Chris Claremont, author of X-Men. I've been talking with the Kenner toy people. I would like you to see their new line of Kenner toys, life-size and anatomically correct. Can Santa bring you one of those for Christmas?
Costume number one in the novice division from Poe's Master of the Red Death, the Sun Queen. Costume presented by Pat Thomas. From ElfQuest, Winnowill. Costume designed, made, and presented by Sarah Berger. From ElfQuest, Winnowill. Cerberus, Guardians of Evil. Presented by Mark Strauss and Emmanuel Treason. Designed by Jeff Copeland and made by all three gentlemen. Maeve and the Morrigu. From The Battle Crow's Daughter by Gillian Fitzgerald. From the anthology Amazons 2. Maeve is an Irish princess. The Morrigu is an ancient Celtic war goddess whose symbol was the raven, and who often appeared as a beautiful queen clothed in blood red. Gillian Fitzgerald and Christine Callahan, designed by Geraldine Fitzgerald and Cecilia Constantini, made by those and Chris Callahan. Maeve and the Morrigu. From Dark Crystal, Skeksis Garthen Master and Mystic.
Distant world, a great crystal glittered in the sky. Its brilliance lit the world and the inhabitants were happy. After a time, the Earth Geeks came and did much good. But they were proud, vain. They tried to use the crystal and the light of the three suns to make themselves perfect. Instead, the crystal shattered. Darkness filled the land. Gone too were the glowing Earth Geeks. Their pride had destroyed them and the land suffered. Now the evil Skeksis ruled with an iron hand.
Skeksis, Garthen, Master, and Mystic. From Dark Crystal, worn by Melody Womack. William Jonas Merlin's White Collar Wizard. Are there evil spirits on your factory floor? Is your vice president's undersecretary a witch? Is your accountant possessed? Then give a call to Merlin Associates. Call now. Familiars are standing by.
costume presented by John S. Olson.
Harunian diplomatic mission. The secretary to his most august overlord of Harun does entrust to the Worldcon these two slaves as a gesture of goodwill and fellowship. He presents to you a pair of the priceless natives of the Harunian wastelands of Isis. The overlord trusts that you will accept these gifts, and may they serve you well. On behalf of the overlord of Harun. Costumes presented by Mandy Slater, Carolyn Mitchell, and Walter Campney. Designed and executed by Mandy Slater and Caroline Mitchell. Harunian diplomatic mission. Presented by Lynn Langer and Brian Stork. From the television production of the Martian Chronicles, A Martian. Costume is presented by Susan Evangelidi, who handmade the papier-mâché mask. The entire costume is of her own construction. Susan Evangelidi as a Martian. First, there was Hercules, then there was Conan. Now, just when you thought it was safe to go back into the forest, Smurf Hunters! Cullen and Tom Mundy. Paul Cullen and Tom Mundy as Smurf Hunters. Segura, Empress of the Spider Realm. Is presented by Cynthia Morgan. Designed and made by Winston A. Howland. Cynthia Morgan as Segura, Empress of the Spider Realm. Bird as the Empress of the Universe from Chinese mythology. Designed and built and by the costumer. Julie Zetterberg, the Silver Surfer. Alan David Laska as the Silver Surfer.
Sylvia of Quercus, High Priestess of the Neo-Druids, a character from her novel, The Romulan Encounter. An oak tree and mistletoe, the plants that are sacred to the Druids, are depicted on her cape. Its color symbolizes the light of a star of type G2. The Neo-Druids are a group of botanists and astronomers who left Earth in the 22nd century to escape intolerant governments and gypsy moths. They established a settlement on a distant planet, taking with them only a few oak saplings and Stonehenge. Carol Botteron as Sylvia of Quercus from the Romulan Encounter. Memory of the Dark and Changing Moon from The Sable Moon by Nancy Springer. Presented by Alexandra Hines, designed and created by Alexandra Hines. Memory of the Dark and Changing Moon. From Battlestar Galactica, the Battlestar Galactica costume. Bird of Paradise. Geraldine Sylvester as Bird of Paradise. And that's a novice division entry, folks. From Marvel Comics, Daredevil, the Man Without Fear. Costume presented by Ira Perlow. Made by Ira, and of course the designer was the comic artist for Marvel Comics. Ira Perlow as Daredevil, the Man Without Fear.
Commander of the Imperial forces, Darth Vader, tall and threatening in his black helmet, glowing black cape, and a face forever masked by a foreboding metal breath screen. Darth Vader, a figure who moves forever in a cloud of awesome evil.
Costume made by Yvonne Penny, electronics by Dan Lozinski. Karza the Barbarian Princess. Presented by Tracy Jean Warner. Karza the Barbarian Princess. Carol Salami as Princess Leia's coronation gown and cape. Ladies and gentlemen, those are integrated circuit discs, dies in the hundreds, if not thousands. By Carol Salemi, created by Carol Salemi, and presented by Carol Salemi. Elven Swordswoman. Costume number 23 in the Novice Division. Elven Swordswoman, Signy. Costume presented by Cam Nihan. Elven Swordswoman, Kaini. From Blake's Seven. Designed and made by Kathleen O'Shea. Blake from Blake's Seven. Jane Naaf Ruth Renunciate from the Darkover series. Jane Cordingly as Jane Naaf Ruth Renunciate. From Lord of the Rings, Aragorn and Arwen. Designed by Patricia Osborne, made by Patricia Osborne, presented by Ray Stevens and Pam Osborne, Aragorn and Arwen. From Gilbert and Sullivan, The Sorcerer. Presented by Jeffrey Landau, The Sorcerer, John Wellington Wells. From the past comes two. When men were men, women were women, and Smurfs were Smurf the Barbarian and Blue Sonia. Costume presented by April Barber and William Quick, Smurf the Barbarian and Blue Sonia. Forbidden Rendezvous. Rejecting a state-arranged union. Princess Female and her companion beast, Queltar, secretly escape into the wilderness to bond with her chosen love, the ambassador to Rigel IV, Shiar. The costumes are based on an original idea by the Flynns. The costume is worn by John and Dorsey Flynn, John Garrity, and Dan Coggins. Forbidden Rendezvous. were designed and constructed by John Flynn. The papier-mâché masks and makeup were created by Dorsey Flynn, John and Sandy Garrity. John and Dorsey Flynn, John Garrity, Daniel Coggins. Double Night. Presented by Tyler Smith. The seasons in review.
Here now is the pageant of the seasons as we experienced it over the past year. Winter, in her stern and stately majesty, extended her dominion over the land until right around Christmas, when spring made an early appearance, spreading joy, playfulness, and flash floods. But winter prevailed again, and in her defiance, held sway for month after month. Damn it. And when spring finally managed to banish winter at last, there came the sudden harsh blaze of summer, driving off spring and leaving not even a memory. And summer has stayed. And stayed. And stayed. And we can only assume that summer will eventually be followed by autumn. Maybe.
That's Eve Schwengel, Thalia St. Louis, Sherry Katz, and Gretchen Van Dorn, the seasons in review. But Scott Rivard thought you would like to see, from Paramount Pictures, the original medical uniform from Star Trek II, The Wrath of Khan, designed and produced by Paramount Pictures. That is Scott Rivard wearing the original medical uniform from The Wrath of Khan. From Doctor Who, Leela. Costume presented by Pat Ritter. Costume made and worn tonight by Pat Ritter. From Doctor Who, Leela. A unicorn witch. Costume presented by Nola Jurgen, designed and made by Nola and Jean Jurgen. Unicorn witch. of the Isle. And from that impeccable arbiter of taste, La Madame Clarisse L'Etrange, we present this simple gown, convenient but elegant for wear around the castle and grounds. The loose drape of the velvet fabric is brought in and pinned to the waist and comes off the shoulders into a full-length cap. The train will please even the most fashion-conscious, but the cut is high in back for ease of movement, uniquely suitable to the chaste maiden. She spells that C-H-A-S-E-D, that's Frances Supernant, Frances Kirk Supernant, as Lady of the Isle. Costume number 36 in the recreation division. From the film Dawn of the Dead, a flesh-eating zombie. Presented by Brian Boskind, Flesh-Eating Zombie. From Dragon Singer by Anne McCaffrey, a Journeywoman Harper. Marjorie Adler as a Journeywoman Harper. Costume designed and made by its presenter, Marjorie Adler. A pig guard, Wee Kuei, and Luke Skywalker. From the Return of the Jedi, of course. Richard Willett, Londo Massey, and Bruce Rushauer as pig guard, Wee Kuei, and Luke Skywalker. Costumes designed by Tim Davis, Chuck Payne, and Londo Massey, and made by the same. Dark Phoenix from X-Men Comics. Presented by Nancy Rogers. Designed by Marvel Comics, made by Nancy Rogers, its presenter, Dark Phoenix. The Four Alignments from Dungeons and Dragons. Presented by Chorley Gorank, Linda Roth, Christine Bunt, and Rich Mahadi. A medieval princess. Presented by Barbara Simon. Designed and hand-sewn by Barbara Simon. Its wearer. Amdar Vartrax.
costume worn by Kevin Maguire. Designed and created by Kevin Maguire from his own design. From the Camber novels, we have Deryne Court Dress, Chris Noel. Deryne Court Dress, designed and created by Chris Noel. Sarah L. Fensterer as Ula from Return of the Jedi. From the film Andromeda Stories, Hero of Andromeda. Hero from the Andromeda Stories, worn by Simon Catt, designed and created by Simon Catt. Fans know that the Master lost at Logopolis. But if the Master had won, this is one version of what could have happened. Much to Nisa's and Adric's horror, while the Master was shrinking the Doctor, he regenerated into a fire lizard. Costume presented by Nancy Mildebrandt, Glenn and Glenn Butcher, Jr. Designed by Nancy Hildebrandt and made by Nancy Hildebrandt, the Master finally wins from Doctor Who. Costume number 47, a Bem. That is Kelly McMahon as a BEM, designed and constructed by J.D. Street. Aurora, the Rainbow Warrior. Costume presented by Trudy Leonard, designed and created by Trudy Leonard. Trudy Leonard as Aurora. An Apprentice Exotic from Gordy Dixon's Soldier Ask Not. Amy Przenski as Apprentice Exotic. Costume designed by Janet Johnston. From Buck Rogers, Princess Ardala.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Ross as Princess Ardala from Buck Rogers. Sorceress of the Elements. In the inner sanctum has gathered the Council of Magic Workers and their apprentices. They have been summoned because someone among them has dared to upset the balance of nature itself. An unforgivable offense. The last to enter the chambers is both accuser and judge. She prepares here for the trial to come, drawing deeply from the energies of the elements she governs. She is Mayfeen, sorceress of the elements. Accompanying her is her apprentice, Dennis, who bears the silver goblet. Through the cup, Mayfeen draws all of her power, storing him in the crystal orb of her staff of office. Carrie Fan and Maria Bukhar, Sorceress of the Elements. Costume designed and created by Carrie Ann Bukhar. Shobi Desh. This well-traveled commodities broker frequently winds up behind bars, but not the kind that serve drinks. Law enforcement agencies object to his solution to female unemployment. Costume designed and worn by Mike Cole. From Time Bandits, Robert. Greg Cantor as Robert from Time Bandits. Lady Lilandra Peacock. Presented, worn and designed and constructed by Sandra Schreiber. Sandra Schreiber as Lady Lilandra Peacock. Domino Chance from the comic. Costume presented by Edmund Sanchez, designed by the comic artist and made by Terry Sanchez. Little Orphan Wookie and Daddy Starbucks. Of mental magic, Lord Rees and Lady Evane of Caldy are presented. Rees as noted as a gentle and compassionate Draini healer. Lady Evane is the sensual sorceress entangled in the religious and political upheavals currently sweeping the land. These two, although most innocent, must bear the tragic price of position and heritage. Costume designed by Janet Johnston, inspired by the legends of Camber of Caldy by Catherine Kurtz. Portrayed by Janet C. Johnston and Anthony Stanley Przinski, Jr. Lord Rees and Lady Evane. From Return of the Jedi, Jabba's newly acquired slave. Gutso, as the princess, Jabba's newly acquired slave. From the Oz books, Glinda the Good and Scraps the Patchwork Girl. Costume presented by Margaret M. Howes and Joan Marie Verba. Costume designed and built by Margaret W. Howes. costume by B. Krebs, Tiet Knapp, A. Verasano, and Yasner, Return of the Jedi. Captain Tawny Dark Falcon. Presented by Michelle Ellington. Designed and built by Michelle Ellington.
Proud annals of the Corps Diplomatique Terrestrienne, or CDT, none surpasses Ambassador Nitpick's brilliant and subtle negotiating with Ambassador Moth of Luna. Seen here, Nitpick is de rigueur in early evening hyper-formal ceremonial wear, as suitable for the semi-tropical zone of a Type G planet. Naturally, since this style is based on ancient Worldcon masquerade costumes, it contains the regulation 13,473½ sequins. Under the sponsorship of the Panel for Alien Uplift, Protection, Enlightenment and Relief, or Pauper, a treaty was signed with the indigenous natives of Luna. Pauper allocated 6 gross of roller skates, an automatic tombstone factory, 100 cybernetic confessional stalls, and 12 billion galactic credits to aid the Loonies. Never has the efficiency of close cultural rapport been better displayed than in the comradeship exhibited by Ambassador Nitpick and Ambassador Moth.
Curtis and Robbie Dyer as ambassadors extraordinaire of the CDT. Designed by Robbie Dyer and made by Curtis Dyer. Batu. Costume presented, designed and worn and made by Bob Johnston. Bob Johnston as Batu. Jay Kingston and Barbara Stock as Garthorian Queen and Imperial Guard. Costume designed and made by Jay Kingston. Elric, the White Wolf, from the Elric books by Michael Moorcock. Kendall Morris as Dwellers of Elvenwood. Costume designed by Ann Morris, made by Ann Morris. From Thieves' World, Robert Asprin. The Mages of Sanctuary, Lythanda, tall, lean magician whose brow bears the blue star tattoo of the Adept, who wields the quickest blade in Sanctuary, who smiles often in mockery, never in merriment. Inas Yorl. The power of his spells is not enough to lift the curse put on him long ago that makes his shape change without warning, at random. Pierre and Sandra Pettinger as mages of sanctuary, costumes made by Kelly O'Donico, a mercenary. Costume presented by Jay Hutchnecker. Mercenary. Costume presented by Carl S. Rasmussen and Trudy Myers. From Anne McCaffrey's book, Myth Presentations. Zandi as Boba Fett.
For your pleasure comes a sensitive entertainer from the distant, exotic pleasure planet Argelius, presenting Amontus, whose name means love.
Amantis from Star Trek. Lucifer, Prince of Darkness. Costume presented by Arthur L. Long, Jr. Thank you.
of darkness and their ladies. Death, delusion, night.
Costumes are presented by Barb Schofield, Martin Miller, Caroline Julian, Richard Hill, Barb Dixon, Serge Maglio, Byron Connell, Alicia Garber, and Dave Shiner. Schofield, Caroline Julian, constructed by Barb Schofield, Caroline Julian, and Martin Miller. Construction assistants, Maureen Bounds, Alexandra Hines, Jack Pegg, Barb Dixon, Stephen Dixon, makeup by Richard Hill. Music and stage presentation arranged by Martin Miller. Banner pole construction by Joe Markovic. The Demon Lords of Darkness. Costume number 75, in the novice division, trainer waiting for Peggy to grow. Costume presented by Ann Allen, designed and constructed by Ann Allen, trainer waiting for Peggy to grow. From the comic book Micronauts, King Acro Year. Presented by Jim Bergstrom. This is recreation costume. Jim Bergstrom as King Acro Year. Lady of Camelot. Costume presented by Paige Eileen Lewis. Designed and made by Paige Eileen Lewis. What's 7 feet tall, white, furry, and runs around the Himalayan mountains with a sword? A Yeti knight, of course. Costume designed, created, and worn by Mark Roth. A Yeti knight. Welsh, Samurai Woman. From The Empire Strikes Back, Bosk, Bounty Hunter.
costume designed, made, and presented by Blade Galantine. Bosk, Bounty Hunter. A robot from an unidentified star system. I am a robot from an unidentified system with a message from my creator. If you expect my robots to obey the three laws of robotics, Earth had better cooperate. Costume designed, made, and presented by David Plott. From Return of the Jedi, Ewok Village Garb. Presented by Deborah Douglas. Designed and made by its presenter from ElfQuest, Winnowill. Costume presented by Cynthia Holmes and made by Cynthia. Cynthia Holmes as Winnowill from The Wrath of Khan, Star Trek II, Lieutenant Savick. Victoria Prober as Lieutenant Savick. Costume was made by its wearer. Yeah. We are privileged here today to present Sirena, Queen of the Jun Horde, Storm Eagle of the Great Plain, Executor of the Collective Will, Chief Nasty of a nasty, nasty band of thieves, cutthroats, rapists, and rustlers ever to darken the prairie. Appearances can be deceiving. And Thug, her personal sword arm, as well as a few other uses. For safety reasons, we request the audience keep their boos and hisses to a minimum. No. M-I-N, minimum. Cheryl Waterfield and Ronald D. Miles. Mark Vittorini and Neil Bates. Made by Vittorini and Bates. Admiral Kirk and Khan. That is Matthew Brady as Godzilla. Don't let him step on the Toyota. It's probably mine. Bomber, Cat, and Irma. As Half-Orc and Valkyries. Costume designed, created, and presented by Bomber, Cat, and Irma. Shara Ordower as a priestess of Arachne Solaris. Costume designed and created by Shara Ordower. The turn of a friendly card.
Karen and Kelly Turner, David and Marianne Myers. From the X-Men, from Marvel Comics, Ariel. That's Rosalind Archambault from X-Men, Ariel. Our next three contestants
first,
wear costumes
whose design was inspired
made
by a natural phenomena. The Doppler shift.
Just for the pun of it.
Next, a costume inspired by the television series Doctor Who. With apologies to Aesop, here is the TARDIS and the hare. Finally, the galaxy-wide famous rock star from Darkover, here is Elton John.
Doppler shift designed, constructed, and worn by Patricia Osborne. TARDIS and hair designed, constructed, and worn by Nancy Fees. Elton John designed and worn by Paul Hammer, constructed by Patricia Osborne. Costumes made just for the pun of it. Mother and child. Presented by Carrie Littler, designed and constructed by Carrie Littler, hand-sewn design by Carrie, mother and child. The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy says that the towel is the most massively useful thing an interstellar hitchhiker can have. You can wrap it around your head to avoid the gaze of the ravenous book bladder beast of Trawl. Mind-bogglingly stupid animal, it assumes that if you can't see it, it can't see you. Daft as a brush, but very, very ravenous. Presented by Valerie Matthews, John Cullis, Ginny Fleming, and Dutch and Brenda Dunham. The ravenous bug bladder beast of Tal. Designed by Valerie Matthews. From Traveler in Black by John Brunner. The Traveler in Black. Many of you have heard of John Brunner's Traveler in Black. What you might not know is that the Traveler has recently taken an interest in physical fitness. So in adding to the Traveler's many names, but still keeping to his one nature, may I present the Jogger in Black. Glenn Rousham as the Jogger in Black. Presenting Fire and Ice with their backup band singing. Wait a minute. It seems that their backup band happened to be playing on a certain sand barge during a certain battle. Needless to say, these ladies need a new backup band. A choir afterwards in the lobby. Kirsten Stahlberg and Linda Reed as Fire and Ice. Thank you.
Kathy and Drew Sanders as King and Queen of Wands. Costume designed by Kathy Sanders, manufactured by Kathy with Helise Holden, wands by Rusty Daw. From the Snow Queen. Her unique scepter symbolizes the last leaves of autumn with the first frosts of winter, the Snow Queen. Costume presented by Jane Nyberg, designer Tracy Warner. The Snow Queen. Suzanne Page as Deirdre from the Chronicles of Amber.
Hi.
Roger Zelazny. From Dragon Riders of Pern, a Southern Dragon Raider. Beth Roberts and Julie Freeman, Southern Dragon Raider. From the Dragon Riders of Pern by Anne McCaffrey.
Of the Mediterranean, the moon was a goddess who appeared in three forms. The new moon was the maiden, symbol of youth and new growth. The full moon was the matron, symbol of fertility. Waning moon was the crone, symbol of death and decay. Together, they make up the three-part goddess.
Roberta Rogow, Louise Rogow, and Lynn Holdem, the triple goddess. Costume design and construction by Roberta Rogow. From television, Dr. Who? Lee Irwin Schlesinger as Dr. Who. Historical France, the Battle of Alesia, Celtic, 52 BC. Bruce Day, presenter. Designed and manufactured by Bruce Day.
Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road.
Dusty Jones as Dorothy Gale. The ambassador from Orgasmia. Jo Dittrich as Ambassador from Orgasmia. Denise Freeman presenting a trained Jedi Knight. Costume design and construction by Denise Freeman. Side crossing by A.E. Norse. By Janet Wilson with lighting by Jim Klaus. Sunrise of Mercury. Retaron from the planet Lyceris. Bruce Porter presenting Retaron from the planet Lyceris. Designed and made by Bruce Porter. A lost in space spacesuit. Presented by Betsy Simon, hand-sewn by Betsy Simon, made by Betsy Simon. Lost in Space spacesuit. Now designed by Air Tay for the 1927 production of Aladdin at the Folies Bergère, here are the Spirits of Fire. By Yvonne Penny. Presenting Marilee Esilt, Princess of Hastur, Keeper of Aralyn, Lady of Darkover, Spar Servu. Kovalson as Merrily Elsit, Keeper of Arelin. From ElfQuest, Rickland Powell as Skywise. Thank you.
Eddie Mercier and Philip Mercier as Time Tripper.
Costumes designed and manufactured by Catherine Mayer. Mayor, Patty Mercier, Philip Mercier as Time Tripper. The Adventures of Doctor Who Cares. The silence of a peaceful morning on the outskirts of some distant colony is broken by a strange sound. It is a galactic nail being drawn across the cosmic blackboard. An object materializes. Once again, the plots of evildoers are doomed by the intervention of that wanderer through space and time, Doctor Who Cares. Having landed in the city dump, the Doctor is pleased to see that his tardy has assumed an appropriate disguise. Of course, this particular tardy has looked like this ever since being tuned by Honest Fred's vehicle shop. And the Doctor always travels with his favorite faithful robot companion, Q9. Our intrepid adventurers will need all of their wits about them, for this once happy colony is being threatened by the Doctor's oldest enemies, the evil Dialets, whose victims' aim it is to tie up every telephone line in the galaxy. Only the courage, ingenuity, and dedication of Doctor Who Cares and Q9 can save civilization from the horror of an eternity of busy signals. But Doctor, wait! Where are you going? Come back. Sarah Bronstein as Doctor Who, The Adventures of Doctor Who Cares, Max and the Gyro Captain. Heiser and M. Duncan McCulloch as Max and the Gyro Captain. From A Rose for Ecclesiastes by Roger Zelazny, McQuay the Matriarch. Girardeau, McQuay the Matriarch, from A Rose from Ecclesiastes. Princess Leia Organa, Fiona Leonard as Princess Leia Organa, from Return of the Jedi. Designed and produced by the Leonard family. Hygorian Nomad. Carl Hopf as a Hygorian Nomad. Hillary Francis as Morticia. Hicks and Kenneth Hilliard as Raven and Captain America. Raven and Captain America, yes.
Deborah Hicks and Kenneth Hilliard, costumes made by Hicks and Hilliard.
Sorceress and hired mercenary. Linda Schneider and Michael Schneider, sorceress and hired mercenary. The Black Knight. Costume presented, designed, and created by Gary Cooper. No, not that character. Gary Cooper, the Black Knight. From Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, a trillion. Trillion has along the Hitchhiker's Everything Pack, which includes a babblefish for translating any unknown language you may encounter. The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. A double pair of Jujanta 200 superchromic peril-sensitive sunglasses. And, of course, the every-necessary towel, something no Hoopy Fruit in his rider left mind could be caught without. Elliot Smith as a Trillion from Warlord, a comic book, Tara. De Oregano, Tara, from the Warlord. In the Novice Division, a short interlude.
Hi, I'm a famous wizard. My line of work demands quick thinking and fast reflexes, so I can't afford to get filled up. That's why I drink light beer from Lankmark. So the next time you're down in the dungeon, remember to take along plenty of Lankmar Light. Come along, my dear. Let me show you a little trick I picked up in Tangiers.
Mike Jones, Patrick Jones, and Marcia Allen. A short interlude.
The Female Warrior. Jordan, the Female Warrior. Costume designed and constructed by its wearer.
Out of the mists of time comes the legend of a land called Camelot. King Arthur and Lady Guinevere. He made goodness and purity ideals to fight for. She was a true Christian woman who held the soul of the kingdom in her hand. There was Lady Morgan, Arthur's sister, a necromancer and follower of the old ways. She thought she could ruin her brother with her sorcery, and when that failed, she used her fertility as her weapon. And there was Mordred, Arthur's and Morgan's son. He learned to despise his father as he hated his mother. He was the destroyer and the destroyed, the power no one could control.
Suhu Abramovitz, Don Cook, Kathy Hillers, King Arthur's family.
Costumes designed and made by their presenters. While the masquerade director is on the stage taking all the bows, there is a staff slaving behind the curtain ensuring the masquerade runs on time. It is hard work, and with that in mind, we present the final costume dedicated to Marty Geer, entitled Deputy Director of the Masquerade, The Day After. By George Pazel, Lori Meltzer, and Don Weiner.
The Constellation Masquerade was judged on the skills division system, first used 2 years previously at the World Science Fiction Convention in Denver. Stated simply, contestants under 13 years old were classed as young fans and were judged as a separate group. Contestants who appeared for the first time at a World Science Fiction Convention masquerade were novices. Any contestant who had entered a previous Worldcon masquerade, but who had won less than 3 major awards, were journeymen, while the contestants who had won 3 or more major Worldcon masquerade awards were masters. Recognizing that it takes a different set of skills to recreate a costume that had been seen by millions of people, Constellation also established a recreation division for costumes based upon movies, television shows, comic strip characters, or any medium in which 2 or more views of the character were shown. Within each division, the judges were given the freedom to award as many or as few prizes as they wished. However, there could be only 1 best in class in each division. Additional prizes were given for workmanship, which required a special judge backstage to examine the costumes closely for details that could not be seen readily from the audience. The contestants had the option of competing up, that is, in a higher division than the one they were qualified for, but never in a lower one. Nearly 5 hours and 135 entrants later, the Constellation Masquerade drew to a close, with the judges making the final awards. In the novice division, Sue Abramowitz, Don Cook, Kathy Hilvers, Eric Foskett, for King Arthur's Family, won Most Beautiful. Carl Hoff, the Hygorian Nomad, won Best Bug-Eyed Monster. Diane Jordan's Female Warrior was not only most audacious, but to the audience's surprise, John Jordan won the Best Workmanship Award for the leatherwork. Valerie Matthews, John Callis, Ginny Fleming, Tom Milton, Dutch, and Brenda Dunham, the ravenous bug bladder beast of trowel, won Most Humorous. Nola Jurgens' Unicorn Witch was judged Most Original. The top prize in the novice division went to Julie Zetterberg, Empress of the Universe, based upon the Gilbert and Sullivan operetta. In the journeyman division, Jim Bergstrom's King Akrahir won Best Comic Character from Another Medium. Paul Cullen and Tom Mandy, the Smurf Hunters, were most appreciated by the judges. Alexandra Hines, Menwi of the Dark and Changing Moon, was most beautiful. Len Kaminsky, Elric, the White Wolf, most authentic. Eve Schwingel, Thalia St. Lewis, Sherry Katz, and Gretchen Van Dorn, 1983, The Seasons in Review, were most humorous. But best in class in the journeyman division went to John and Dorsey Flynn, John Garrity, Daniel Coggins, for Forbidden Rendezvous. In the recreation division, Sarah Berger's Winnow Whip was best comic character. Susan Evangelidy, the Martian from the Martian Chronicles, was the best TV presentation. Deborah Hicks and Kenneth Hilliard, Raven and Captain America, was the best Marvel DC Comics team-up. Wendy Ross's Princess Ardala from the Buck Rogers TV series was most beautiful. But top prize in recreation went to Matthew Brady, Godzilla. In the master division, Catherine Mayer, Patty and Philip Mercier, The Time Tripper, based on the Mike Chitlov short film, won Most Beautiful and Inventive. Kathy and Drew Sanders, King and Queen of Wands, was judged Most Graphic, while Karen and Kelly Turner, David and Marianne Myers, Diane and Rusty Daw, Brian Mix, and Natalia Quirk, Turn of a Friendly Card, was the most beautiful presentation and also won the Contestant's Choice Award. Janet M. Wilson, Sunrise on Mercury, was judged Most Beautiful Solo Presentation. But the best in class in the master division went to Barb Schofield, Martin Miller, Carolyn Julian, Richard Hill, Barb Dixon, Sergei Malyo, Brian Connell, Alicia Garber, David E. Schneier,